move on. We said baroque music is like a teenager. Okay, let's just do a little bit of rewinding. Rachel, in what way is baroque music like a teenager? Like you. Organized, okay? We can go with that. It's not completely organized. It's quite organized, but not so organized yet. What else is there? Kevin, in what other way is baroque music like a teenager? Very, very good. It's dramatic. Okay? It's full of sudden changes. One final one. Oh, very, very good. It's full of emotion. It is full of emotion. And you know, you and I have spent quite a bit of time looking at the musical characteristics that make this music sound like a teenager. We've looked at how it's perhaps not as organized as it could be. You know, we've looked at how it's dramatic. We've looked at the sudden changes. We've looked at the emotion that comes with the baroque music. And then we also talked about fast-forwarding it by a few hundred years and going to the music of the classical period. So if baroque music is like a teenager, remember we talked about it, what is classical music like? So baroque music grew up and became classical music, which Scarlett says, is like a young adult. And we talked about imagining yourselves in about 10 years' time. What are some of the characteristics of classical music? Okay, it's organized, it's logical. Yeah, it's no longer uncontrolled. It's no longer somebody who's just trying different things out. This is somebody who knows what he or she is doing. And he goes around with a purpose. We also looked at how classical music no longer had the sudden terrace dynamics, right? Not terrace, they were controlled, right? What would you say? Usually you were trying to say something. Harpsichord disappeared. Harpsichord was from the Baroque period, remember?
It's replaced by the piano.
Okay, good, it's replaced by the piano. So what's the main difference between piano and harpsichord? Did we talk about it? All right. Very good. Piano has pedals. So? Molly, so?
Some notes can be controlled for more time.
Very, very good. Rachel, what did she say?
So the notes can be controlled.
Very good. Harpsichord, guys, remember, doesn't have pedals. What are pedals, Carol? Very good, we control them with our foot, the pedal. And the harpsichord doesn't have, I think harpsichord doesn't have the pedal. So as a result, harpsichord can only play very, very loud or very, very soft. That's why baroque music has terrace dynamics. Whereas piano allows you to control the dynamics. You can hold the notes. And as a result, classical music is more controlled. We talked about how the composer used certain symbols to control the dynamics. What are the Italiano names for this?
Whose voice have I not heard?
Scarlett! What is this arrow? You know what it means, right? This arrow means?
Crescendo.
What is crescendo? Good, slowly getting louder and stronger. And then we've got the opposite, which is called, Flora? Very, very. And that, of course, means you slowly become softer. And this is something that was missing from the Baroque scores, largely because the harpsichord could not play this. The piano could play these things. So as a result, the composer started to take control of the music. He says, I will tell you when to get loud. I'll tell you how loud to get. He also decided that he would use some beautiful symbols. What is MF? First of all, when you see MF, Jerry, what does it mean when you see MF in your music? If you're playing the oboe and you see MF, it means? Very good. Medium strong, medium loud. And MF in Italiano is mezzo forte. Mezzo forte, medium loud. And of course, when you see F, it means loud. And F is
forte.
And then when you see two Fs, it is fortissimo. Very good. And when there are three Fs, it is
fortissimo.
Bueno. Fortissimo. And again, these things you will not see in a traditional Baroque score. Because the composer did not control the music. The person performing the music did. The harpsichord controlled everything because the harpsichord could not play these things. On the other side of the scale, we then had the P's. Yvonne, when you see P, you know it's soft. Can you explain P in a forte voice? P means? What does it stand for? Piano, very good. And so MP is? What is MP? Carol? Mezzo piano, medium soft. And PP is pianissimo. And PPP is
pianissimo.
See? Choose music and you'll also learn Italian. And finally, we reach the topic that you and I are looking at today. So today we're going to look at the changes that take place in romantic music. And we're going to look at the musical characteristics, okay? So romantic music, remember there are two names. Sometimes they call it romantic music, sometimes they refer to the time period. Scarlett, which period is the romantic music from?
19th century.
Very, very good. 19th century. Guys, please, please remember both the words because in the exam, they may use romantic music, they may use 19th century music, and it's okay. Both these terms are perfectly acceptable. So now I'm going to ask you to imagine again. Once upon a time, there was a student called Kevin Wong. He went to Dulwich International High School. He was a teenager who was full of emotion. He could not control himself sometimes. And sometimes he got angry. Sometimes he would be very soft and gentle. However, when Kevin grew up, yeah, at 25 years old, Kevin went to MIT. Kevin became a very successful engineer. Kevin was always organized. He thought about everything very clearly. He could control himself. One day, he met a friend from his year 10 music class. Who shall he meet? Who do you think he should meet? Who? William.
Oh,
can we choose a girl?
Carol.
Okay, Carol. He met his year 10 classmate Carol. And guess what happened? They fell in love. They got married. They had two children. And the children also went to Dulwich International High School. And they were also tortured by Miss Sid. Okay? The children grew up. The children went to university. Kevin was about 45 years old. Kevin started to lose his hair. Kevin now weighed 50 kilograms heavier than he used to. Whenever Kevin walked, his knees hurt, his back hurt. Heaven was middle-aged. What is a middle-aged person? Kevin is about 45 years old. His hair is dropping. Imagine, Kevin is 50 kilograms heavier. Kevin's knees hurt. And when he walks, he goes, ew, what a yawa. So, what is it? What is middle-aged?
12.
Yeah, 40 to 50-something, 60 years old. At that time, you know, your body starts to change. It's just a fact of life. Your body will start to change. Yeah, William has a lot of beautiful hair on his head now. Yeah. I don't know. In 30 years' time, I don't know whether William will. And it's okay. We will still love William, even if his head, he starts to lose his hair. But what I'm trying to say is, it's like a middle-aged person. Your body is changing. Your mood is changing. Think of it. How would you feel? I'm going to give you about 30 seconds now. How do you think you would feel? You would feel. As a middle-aged person. It's not all bad, by the way. In fact, it's very, very nice to be middle-aged. What are some changes you'll be going through? I'm going to give you 1 minute to talk to your friend about it. Okay. Imagine your life as a middle-aged person. It's probably difficult for you to imagine. Once upon a time, I couldn't even imagine myself as a 20-year-old. And now I think of myself with a walking stick, and I say, oh my gosh, it's coming soon. And sometimes you might feel a bit frustrated. What does it mean when you're frustrated? I cannot run as fast as I used to. I get frustrated. But it's okay. I can't run, but I can still walk quite fast. Yeah. But yes, frustrated, you feel a little bit... How do you feel when you're frustrated, Melody? So guys, we've got these aspects of a middle-aged person. Sometimes frustrated, but generally still quite contented, still quite happy with life. You will be rich. You have a lot of resources. Because you've worked for a long, long time. Your mind will be rich because you have lived for quite a long time. So you're no longer a young, immature teenager. You are somebody who has a lot of ideas. You're very confident because you know what you're doing. You're not afraid of what people say. Like Flora says, all right, I'm fat, who cares? Good. Sometimes you get a bit frustrated. But that's okay, that's part and parcel of life. Now what I'm going to have you do is, guys, we're going to listen to a piece of romantic music, and we're going to look at how is it like a middle-aged person. In what way is the music full of ideas? Okay, musical ideas are different. What other resources are there in music? How does it show you that this person is a very, very confident person? He or she doesn't really care what you think, okay? And get full of emotion. All these are feelings, right? Contentment, confidence, frustration. Sometimes this person is very, very, very happy, but there are also signs that suggest this person might be a little bit frustrated, a little bit lonely. And so your task for now is, listen to the music and discuss with your friend how it reminds you of a middle-aged person. And because this is a music class, you can use fancy music terms. You can talk about things like the melody. Is it diatonic? The range of notes. Are there a lot of notes or just a few little notes? We look at the phrases. Are they organized or not so organized? said that it's very, very logical. Everything has almost got a formula. Yvonne, what are the main chords we use in classical music? Do you remember? There are three chords that we use. I give you 10 seconds to look up the name of the three chords. What are the three main chords that they use in classical music? Molly, you remember? Good. It's very, very organized, and we focus on three main chords. Diatonic, and what's the other one? Very good. Subdominant and?
Dominant.
And dominant. This is what was used in the classical period. What about now? Don't worry if you're not able to label the chords, but you should be able to tell me whether they are mostly diatonic or not so diatonic. If it sounds funny to you, tell me. Third thing is, what about things like dynamics? Do you hear a lot of dynamics? If you have to label the music using PPP, pianissimo, all the way through to fortissimo, how would you do it?
Imagine yourself.